Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Who are these guys even? Holy shit, these Belfast levels. Combination of NA and SA? What, they were Chinese? You think Jaro is Costabil? I don't know who that is. I don't follow much of the tier 2 scene.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
So many Brazilian players that play. There was like one guy in the past, but then he got banned from Valve events or something.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
There were multiple and they're all from Peru. Alright.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
No more weeb music. It's time for real music.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Is this just in the sea? Caught in the end time. No strength come free. Allergy. Open for eyes.
I'm gonna get a drink, Braddock.
To the skies and sea.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
He's the leader of the bunch. You know him well.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
To kick some tail. His coconut gun can fire in spurts. If he shoots,
I'll take that.
It's gonna hurt.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And stronger too. He's the first member of the DK group.
Better than a Fultis.
DK. Lucky Kong. DK. Donkey Kong is here!
This Kong's got style, so listen up to...
She can shrink in size to suit her mood.
She's quick and nimble when she needs to be.
She can float through the air and climb up trees.
If you choose her, you'll not choose wrong.
With a skip and a hop, she's one cool Kong. DK! Donkey Kong! DK! Donkey Kong is here! DK!
This song is so amazing that even Queen made a cover of it.
To make you cry. If I knock back again, this time tomorrow. Can he all? Can he all? As if nothing really matters.
He has no style. He has no grace.
This Kong has a funny face.
He can handstand when he needs to.
And stretch his arms out just for you.
Inflate himself just like a balloon.
This crazy Kong just digs his chew.
DK! Donkey Kong! DK! Donkey Kong!
monkey from his head.
Oh, what the fuck is that picture? Never seen the animated Donkey Kong show. I've seen a real life Mario show though. That was some trippy shit.
I don't know
who made the Mario shows, man. I don't remember. So long ago. I just remember they were really fucking weird. It didn't make any sense. I haven't really played that many new games off stream. I'm playing Street Fighter and Guilty Gear a little bit here and there. I played against Yun and won 14 times in a row. I think I'm gonna give mercy just because someone's a girl. I can't get through that game. It's too hard. Thank you, H2PM, for the 33 months. What if she's a hot girl? There is no way you let anybody win in video games just because they're a different gender. There's no way. Thank you, Gam, for the 15. It's a hot dude. A hot, big, muscular, handsome guy. I don't know. I think you beat them all the same way.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is fallen.
Do I have any advice for university graduates who still don't know what to do with their life? Whatever you choose, man, just jerk off before. It's called post not clarity.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I think a lot of people don't know what they're doing. They're like, I don't know, I'm just like following day by day. But then again, I don't really worry, so might be different if you worry about what you want to do. If I had to dispose of a corpse, how would I go about that? I think like the most expensive types of garbage bags you can buy, chop it in pieces, put some bricks in it, tie it up, dump it in the ocean. But don't put them all in the same spot, because they might notice something odd and find out. Thank you, good all for the 5 months. I like that show, man. The Dexter one? Until like season something. Where it became a drama show instead of, you know, Dexter. What about that shit in Breaking Bad with the liquid and carton? I think it's kinda easy to mess up, isn't it? Like, you need an experienced chemist to pull shit like that off. It's probably easy to own like a pig farm or something.
You become past tense.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
I wonder how many people try to make their own crystal meth after watching Breaking Bad. There's at least one guy, for sure. Still out there renting their own van. Nobody can be that dumb. That's what you think, man. Or sometimes they use, they say out loud phone numbers in shows. People fucking call those.
Radiant structures are fortified.
And the whole Tide Pod thing, wasn't that also American? nothing happened at Area 51. That's what you think.
Illusion.
What the fuck?
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
People didn't get killed in Area 51. They got removed. Erased.
Thank
you, where's the best for the 22? What hero next game? I don't know. We'll see.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower has fallen. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I'm not gonna play any Wonderlords patch.
Dire's middle
I played
tower
a good amount
attack.
Of Wonderlords, like 200 hours or something.
Dire's
I've had enough of it.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
I'm not playing Diablo 3, man. Why don't you see me replaying any games I like? What do you mean, dude? I replay games all the time. Played for Sekiro 8 times!
Radiant structures are fortified.
Why not 9? Because the difficulty stops increasing. And I'll play some Noita in a bit. Maybe after this series or so. First time I played the Guardian Ape was amazing. I almost first tried the Guardian Ape. It was close. Then I killed on my second or third try. And then I remember I watched Rain play it. And he was on it for like 3 hours already. I went to sleep, he was still on it. Oh, I did kill it on my first third try or so. All of the bosses were pretty easy after the granny. And then the next hardest boss was like the final boss guy. Like that virgin that always keeps showing up. Genny Geo or whatever. The owl, they were all pretty easy. And then the difficulty goes up again when you play without the charm. Oh, and the fire demon guy was pretty hard. But only because it lasted so fucking long. Yeah, the granny boss wasn't actually that hard. It's just that that's the first boss that teaches you the game. So it's easier than the other bosses, but because you know the game by then, it feels like the other ones are easier. Because in my new game pluses, I pretty much first shot the granny every single time. I barely use the heal even. The owl is pretty hard if you play without the charm, because then you have to parry a shit ton of stuff. And it's easy if you just block. The snake eyes. The snake eyes had this fucking bullshit one-shotting grab attack. Oh my god. Dire's top tower is under attack. There's no game for Sekiro. One of a kind.
Tribute to my house.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is falling.
I don't wanna play Cold Vein anymore, dude. I'm done with that game. I didn't even know there was a whole optional dungeon filled with bosses that were harder than the normal version. It was an okay game, but I don't like how everything is skilled for two players. So basically, you're just hitting bosses with double the HP. Unless you wanna play with the OP companions. Genichiro is where most people quit? I thought that guy was super easy. Also killed that guy on my second or third run. Like, towards the end of the game, I could beat that guy blindfolded almost. Cause he was like the like the mini boss before the main boss at the end. I beat him a lot. A fucking lot.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, the corrupted monk was fun too. It was just like 20 minutes of parrying.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Ha 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 ha
Any interest in Bloodlines 2? Not sure what game that is. Thank you too, Gem, for the Prime. I remember those flying kite guys on the rooftop. The exploding guys that yell. You're like, "Wee!" And then they fly right into your face and explode. I even looked at the kite before I went in and was like, "Huh. What's that thing in the sky?" Yeah, that fucker came out of nowhere. Cold Vein is actually much easier than all other Souls-like games. If you play with a companion, yes. If you play it solo, it is much harder than any of the other Souls games. Including 3. Bosses in Dark Souls just have so little HP in comparison. Some bosses die in like 6 or 7 hits even. You're not killing a Cold Vein boss in 6 or 7 hits. And there's no way 3 was the easiest in the Dark Souls. I'm sure 3 was the hardest one. And 1 was the easiest one. It's only that you've played through 1 and 2 and then 3 gets easy because you know the game already. But mechanically 3 was so much harder. Bosses were so much more chaotic too. Some bosses in Dark Souls 1 were so weak, they died in like 2 or 3 spells.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Where's my pension?
I haven't played so much Assassin's Creed. I only played like the last two of the series. I like the last one. The one set in ancient Greece. Odyssey's late game boss fights were amazing. I didn't stream that, but at some point you fight the Cyclops and Medusa and some other things. It's a poor choice by them to put them all the way at the end.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I'll be streaming Outer Worlds. I didn't finish DMC5. I liked the game until you started playing that cock that kept reciting poetry. Also, I can't stand the characters in DMC5. They smell so fucking weird in DMC5. The shop lady and the main character.
So that we might live better.
And overall, the DMC series is not my type of game. I don't like the idea of playing for high scores. You know, you get like a character that has 10 brilliant moves, but really only like 5 of them are really good, and the rest is just for more points. And I prefer games that make you use moves because you need to use them to survive.
Years. Are you gonna play MHW Iceborne?
Thank you, Arbok, for the 24. I'll play Iceborne when it comes out on the PC, which is next year in January. What happened if I'm streaming Behemoth? I'll fight Behemoth when I play Iceborne. I'll kill them all.
Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack. Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack.
Did they add it? The dragon with the rocket boosters in Iceborne? I guess not, right? It didn't? Oh, that's too bad. That's one of my favorite bosses in all of Monster Hunter games. I fought the Saiyan Gorilla, and it's gonna be fun too. But that guy's more just annoying to play against. Because he just fucking flies around all the time.
Hello sir, first time viewer, can we hear this please?
Oh, the 1000-degree knife guy is there too. The fucking laser tail guy. He's pretty badass. He fights like a samurai dinosaur. That's good shit. What's this song? Why is it called the Big Up Piece?
Hey.
I don't know if they're gonna release more DLC for Monster Hunter World. If Iceborne sells well, I'm sure they will. There's a lot of Monster Hunter veterans waiting for more content, harder content for World. Because the thing with World is that the players are a little bit too strong, I think. I don't know about Iceborne, because I haven't played that yet. But in just the base game, the player was definitely too strong. Oh, the endgame lag. Monster Hunter World is kind of easy mode compared to Monster Hunter XX. Well, it's not necessarily a bad thing. I didn't like the high difficulty so much in all the Monster Hunter games, because it was a lot of just like a monster bumps into you by accident and you die. You know, like he stubs his toe in your face and you're dead. He turns around and you're dead.
Radiant's bottom barracks have fallen.
Come to us. Dominating. I have seen the future.
Monster Hunter World is not that hard to learn. It's actually fairly casual and very forgiving. What song to play? Basher Gyro is next level play. He's gonna bash the void during Chrono with eggs.
Hmm.
These guys make really good music. It's just like some gaming studio that makes it too. It's not a real band. Although the English vocals are questionable sometimes, the lyrics. For sure, sometimes there's some English. Where's my free content? What's that song called? The one something where he yells blazing all the time. Smell of the game, is that the one? Oh, it is this one. Thank you, Brother Song. Thank you, Neot, for the 8 months. Tell Febby to stop cross-dressing. Febby can do whatever he wants, man. If he wants to pretend to be a woman, he can do that too. He can be the prettiest woman of all time, if he chooses to be.
Please tell Febby to stop cross-dressing. That is bullshit blazing. Still my heart is blazing. If the word kill me, I don't need a new word on you.
What the fuck is this?
We already know the smell of the game.
Thank you, Buttersome. Butters OMG. For the 20 sub-gifts. Suddenly out of nowhere.
I'm a performance.
I'm rich!
Bullshit blazing. Still my heart is blazing. If the word kill me, I don't need a new word under you. Soon you will know. We already know the smell of the game. I know who I am. That moonlight lake told me. This is who you are.
I might actually meet Notal tomorrow too. I don't know if he's gonna go.
I'm a performance artist.
And thank you for another 20, dude. Ah, shit. One credit card. I did have some incidents before, but I don't think this is. Usually the stolen money ones are more direct donations. Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Butters OMG, for the 40 sub gifts just now.
I'm an artist. I'm a performance
60
artist.
Sub-gifts.
That is bullshit blazing. Still my heart is blazing. If the word kill me, I don't need a new word under you.
Dominating.
Double kill. You know the smell of the game.
I regret nothing.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
That is bullshit blazing. Still my heart is blazing.
And thank you to Mr. HF Sajun for the prime. This song loops the chorus too much, right?
I know who
Oh, this is not the full song? Oh, it's just some guy that looped it, no wonder. Oh, I see. I thought it looped like a little bit too much. I just kept hearing him saying, "This is bullshit blazing." And just kept going. Like, what the fuck? Man, I got baited. That's the one fighting game next year that I'm gonna try to get at least above average in. Hopefully it's not too different from older Guilty Gear games, but usually they stay the same with a couple mechanics added. And some moves changed. Most mechanically intensive mainline fighting game? I'm sure it's fine.
It's not in my nature, but
warriors of the world.
I think I have a good concept on how to play fighting games. I just lack a lot in the practice and execution part. I'm just watching some random guy now, waiting for the next game to start from DreamHack. It should be soon, like any second now. You ever looked up like the guides for Guilty Gear? It is like, what the fuck, dude?
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
You'd think it'd just be like maybe 4 or 5 pages of things you have to know, and it's not. It's like 150 pages of knowledge. Like 3 different animation cancels or something. There's 2 different jump cancels. There's like 10 billion different moves. And then for every fucking character, there's also a different combo because they have different hitboxes. Like, what the fuck? Thank you, Delarian, for the 70 months, man. I've played King of Fighters before. I played the one on the PS1, I think. It's a very long time ago. But I never got good at those games. I was just a kid, so I pressed buttons until I won or lost. And if I lost, I blamed the game. Am I ever gonna get more sub badges? I have to, actually, yeah. Gotta get more. Thank you to Spudea for the 71. Classic fighting games, where you press the buttons harder and faster, they also come out harder and faster.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Thank you, Kalbir, for the 18 months. I'll be playing a little bit of Noita after a couple DreamHack games. At least the next series. And I don't know when Alliance is playing, because I wanted to watch 33 play Dota. Might be the last game, I think. I was actually looking for him.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yes, you can.
I don't think Thieven is on the team right now. He's playing a lot of Underlords. He's like top 10 in the world or something like that. I mean, you know, that's maybe like 15 players, but still it's top 10.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Game up. Let's see. Oh, it is. No lie! There's a rumor Valve is going to re-release Artifact next year. Well, they're gonna do something with it, right? It was such a big investment for them. I think the whole organic growth thing is hard to pull off. It's like they tried to do the same thing with Dota, but Dota already had a player base from Dota 1.
Seconds remaining. Radiant team ban.
I have no idea if they're even making a release. I haven't read anything about it.
Ten seconds remaining. Dire team ban.
The game lacked a proper meta. Like, the meta was figured out before it ever came out, so there was nothing to discover in the game.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I'm sure that game still made money. The banner is Nicolas Cage, and it looks like he's about to bust a nut. Oh, the main menu music.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I'm a Guilty Gear player, but I'm awful, so it's nothing noteworthy. Why am I watching games? I literally played Polym earlier today, man. I won against rank 1 in Europe! And Europe is basically world. Basically. I didn't play that Potemkin guy. I just played Saul Bad Guy because it was the first character introduced. I'm just a normie, man.
Radiant team pick.
I looked up at tournaments for Soul Bad Guy, like, and I noticed that people actually just chain combo in corners forever. I need to start learning that.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Controller or keyboard on Guilty Gear? I don't think I'll ever use a keyboard for fighting games. I'm struggling with motion movements already. I don't think I'd ever pull it off on keyboards. Yeah, it's controllers for me. I use the PS4 DualShock. But I don't like the D-pad on this, so I might get something else. Keyboard is super easy. I think the motions are too hard for keyboard, aren't they? Like doing hall circles? Seems like a nightmare. But doesn't seem to be much advantage anyway between different things that you can use, whether it's controllers or fight sticks or keyboards. I've noticed players, they use all kinds of things, professional ones. Thank you, I'm not K for the 4 months. It's more what people just get used to, rather. The last champion in Guilty Gear used a steering wheel? What?
Da-da-da!
5 seconds remaining.
The fuck
enough
is that?
Enough of this garbage Guilty Gear music, how about some real music?
Oh god. Oh my god. This song cuts. Initial T, the steering wheel warrior. All right. What the fuck?
Radiant team down.
It's not so bad, but you can hear it in both ears.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I think it was a pretty nice game. It was nice. It had some bad level designs here and there, but overall it was a nice game to play through.
Dire team pick.
No, I won't be like you. It was so high in content too. Surprisingly. I kept thinking the game's almost over and it just kept going and going and going.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Choose your hero.
Maybe I'll go back to that game when DLC comes out. It was a season pass I didn't buy. Go for New Game Plus, I guess.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Try and win. All depends on Bambo, man. And Gorg. I think Gorg is sleeping now and he's gonna wake up in a few hours. And Bambo is gone to bed like an hour ago. So yeah, it's difficult. Almost like we're in three different continents, but we're in the exact same time zone. Question marks? Bambo's here? He's not dead. I can't fuck up my sleep schedule, man. I have a dog.
Stand chant.
Is this like Nickelodeon music? What is this? Do I think Podola can be improved in tier 2 and tier 3? That's a very easy way to solve. You need more players. And with more players, you have more viewers. With more viewers, you have more sponsors. With more sponsors, you have more money. And more money is a better tier 2 and 3 scene. So just get more players, dude. And then you get a more healthy tier 2 scene.
Good morning.
Good morning, Ada Blessed. Shadow Fiend, player perspective. Feels good, man. Ah! Oh, that physically hurt me here. Ah, shit, dude. Oh, shit, dude. Oh! One soul. Two souls. Should have raced. Ah, shit. Gotta send out more mangoes, right? Oh, he's rushing bottle. Oh! Oy, 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 oy. At least he got that range creep, didn't I? Do I remember Yafetz? Of course. He's one of those players that make people play Shadow Fiends. I know I started playing Shadow Fiends because of him. What was the video called? Perfect as shit?
Hi.
No, it was something else. It was something else. Thank you, Draconis. For the 21. Was it perfect as shit? Ah, it was that one then. Hmm. HM 87 for the 30 months. Oh yeah, the song. The other guy. Poor Razor. He's supposed to win the lane, but he's not. Now he's getting his ass handed to him. It's already past the point where he can win the lane anymore. He's very reliant on the first few creep waves. But even then, it's not that easy anymore. Ever since they buffed the race so much in damage. I'm not queuing for more Dola. I already played my 3 games of the day. Enough for me. Love getting paid to watch streams? Isn't that weird? You're at your job watching a stream that's watching other people's content, also getting paid for watching it. Isn't that fucking weird? Free content, man. Free content. He's getting fucking bullied, man. Oh shit. Thank you, Pujansha. For the 3 years, man. I'll be at DreamHack tomorrow. Probably visit like for one series or so. R.I.P.
To the underscape with you.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Radiant structures are fortified.
I wonder what the audience is like. Dire's there's many people. Because Dota is not very popular in Netherlands. So I'm assuming that most people that go there, they're from other countries even. Is popular in Netherlands? Fortnite, League of Legends.
Dire's middle tower.
Tickets were mega
attack.
Cheap. Oh, I'm leeching mine off some staff. I don't know what the prices are for tickets. Oh no 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 no, he missed.
New followers.
I think it's fine.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
It's like 16 euros. I think that's about a normal price for a ticket. Unless it's all days. It should be just 16 euros per day. Fortnite and LoL is not just more popular in my country, dude. It's more popular like almost everywhere in the world. Just how things are.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
There's like a few places where Dota is more popular. Maybe like Ukraine, Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And that's about it, really. Russia? Not Singapore, really? I saw a lot of Dota play when I was in Singapore, but that was like 5 years ago, so maybe it changed. CSGO is not that popular here. It used to be really popular. But then all the normie games came out, like Call of Duty and Battlefield. Now those are super popular.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
I always repeat this story at the event of First Look, where there was a stage for Dota 2 and there was a stage for Call of Duty. Dota 2 had like one viewer. There was some old grandpa that walked by and asked what it was. And Call of Duty was completely packed. So packed that people were standing.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And the worst part? They played Call of Duty on the fucking console. Katana Zero, but I know off the game. Thank you, Canvas Back, for the 3 minutes, man.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
A lot of my Singaporean friends that quit Dota, they play fucking mobile phone games now.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
It's bad.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Now that was a failed vote.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
It's really bad.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
It used to be a good StarCraft 2 scene in the Netherlands, but that also died down. That's a shame, really. StarCraft died, but it was like the only game I noticed that had a proper Dutch scene. Dark Hollow M for the 28 months.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Gubby is Dutch, but he doesn't play StarCraft 2, I think. He plays Warcraft still. I like watching Grubby stream. I think he gets mad when you mention that his mouth is open when he's in a tense situation in a game. Who? Grubby, man. He's like the original Dutch pro gamer. He's actually the one that got me into pro gaming. Not him personally, but because he did it, I went for it. Thank you, Vec1, for the 3 months. You're just like a kid. And you look in some magazines and you see some dude that plays video games for money. I was like, what the fuck? He plays video games for money?
Mega kill. Very nice.
Step lively now. Your admiral is on board. Bounty!
Now I play video games for money. He's really fucking good at Warcraft as well. He's playing some 80% win rate accounts. Well, I guess competition is also fairly low now, since it's an old game. My parents were supportive of going, of me going to pro gaming. I mean, not Asian parents, but I still grew up in the Netherlands. I never had the stereotype of Asian parents. Sounds awful. Attack. The only thing that matters are your grades, and you better be a fucking doctor by the end of this year. You better be.
Step lively now. Your admiral is on board.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack.
It takes 4 years to be a doctor. It's a little bit longer than 4 years, isn't it? More like 8. No, lawyers take like 10 years or something. There's no way doctors take 4. Maybe like a nurse or something. Point in being a doctor. Just don't get sick.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
I've never been bedridden before. Not once in my life. I've never been to a hospital before for like broken bones or anything. Only a couple stitches.
Invisibility!
You don't test for STDs in fucking hospitals, dude. What the fuck?
Bounty.
It's like these STDs clinics where you just they take your blood, they send it to a lab, and then they SMS you the results. You would know, of course. It's a responsibility, man. job isn't just about money. It's about contributing to the society, and playing video games doesn't. It's true.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
A lot of things don't contribute to society. I think most things don't, actually. What does contributing to society mean? I guess you give back. In a more, maybe even carbon friendly way? I don't know, it's hard to say, really. Maybe enhance your country's culture? And making really good art? I don't know, dude. If I was a president, I would have the best ideas for entertainment. We'd build a giant arena and make people fight to the death. But here's the thing, they have to train a lifetime for it and they have to agree to it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Unstoppable.
Radiant structures are fortified.